Steve, you know that when you reach 50 years old, you know what happens, right?
Hair falls out.
Not only that, we tend to forget things. I have to write it down because I knew I was going to forget something. Today is the eve of a very special day when we will celebrate the unity of Danny and Rebecca as a scheduling our family.
In misfortune, rich in blessings, slow to make enemies, quick to make friends. But rich or poor, quick or slow, may you know nothing but happiness from this day forward.
Very nice.
Best and to you.
Salute.
Hello everyone, I am the maid of honor. My name is Chica Aglarity. I have known Rebecca and Danny for 6 years. I remember how hard Danny chased Rebecca and how long it took Rebecca to decide whether she liked Danny or not.
To Danny and Rebecca, right? That's how it ends, right?
When you say it calmly,
we had to go up there.
Like,
there was like a lot of pauses, so when you go up there, just take a deep breath before you speak and then gather yourself.
I've known them for 6 years. Rebecca has always been a listening ear and a compassionate heart. I remember when Danny and Rebecca first were trying to get together, I remember how hard Danny chased Rebecca, and I remember how long it took for Rebecca to decide whether she liked Danny or not. Through their relationship, I've watched them grow into beautiful individuals. Rebecca has grown in her generosity and her open-heartedness. I've watched Danny grow in his loyalty and his patience.
Cards throw their shadows.
I'm zooming.
I am not looking my best at all.
The truth is, Danny, the thing I admire about you the most is also what annoys me the most. Danny's the type of guy to set a goal for himself and strive to achieve it. When he has a goal set, nothing can stop him. That is, unless he sets the bar too high for himself.
And as we come to the day and we have this last time to be able to think about the step that you're about to take, and as I have this last opportunity to share with you one last piece of advice, I want to remind you of a passage that's found in Ephesians chapter 6. A passage about submission. But it's not just one to the other. It's really a passage about wives submitting to husbands and husbands submitting to their wives and giving of themselves and pursuing them with everything that they have. And today you guys begin this unbelievable, beautiful journey together. This journey that's going to be full of so many ups and so many downs and twists and turns. And up till now, both of you have lived your stories for you. But in Ephesians chapter 6, the writer is trying to help us understand and see something deeper in what it means to love and what it means to enter into this relationship that you're about to enter into today. But today, as you take these vows to one another, your story changes. And Dan, today, as you take these vows, you lay down your hopes, you lay down your ambitions, you lay down the story of Dan, take up the story of Rebecca. And from this day forward, you no longer live for your hopes and your dreams and your ambitions. You live for hers. And it's no longer what can Dan become. It's no longer what can I become. It's what can she become. How can I help her be everything that God created her to be? How can I help her experience everything God created for her to experience. And Rebecca, the same is true for you. And from this day forward, it's not about Rebecca's story, it's Dan's story. And how can his hopes and dreams and ambitions become a reality? How can he become the man that God created for him to be? And the beauty of true love and what you're about to step into is only realized when both of you willingly today decide to lay aside your story and live for the others. When you submit to one another and you begin to pursue one another and the other's hopes and dreams with everything that you have. And if you're willing to do that, then you will find something that very, very, very few do. Real love. A love that truly is not selfish. Today, as Dan and Rebecca take this step, I pray that they would find themselves in 50 years more in love than they are today. I pray that as they walk through the ups and the downs and the twists and the turns, that not only would they cling to you, but they would constantly be pushing one another towards you. That today, as they begin to live for the other's story, that Dan would find himself constantly dreaming of how Rebecca could know you more, experience you more, walk with you more. And Rebecca would find herself constantly dreaming of how she could help Dan experience you, know you, enjoy you more. Father, you've shown us what it means to love, to live for someone other than ourselves. And I pray that their understanding, experience, and knowledge of you would just begin to explode as they step into this relationship where they're giving of themselves for the one whose hand they hold today. In Jesus' name. I, Dan, take you, Rebecca, to be my wife.
I, Dan, take you, Rebecca, to be my wife.
I promise before God and these friends,
I promise before God and these friends,
to be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To share with you in plenty and in want.
To share with you in plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
And to join with you.
And to join with you.
So that together we may serve God and others.
So that together we may serve God and others.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I, Rebecca, take you, Dan, to be my husband.
I, Rebecca, take you, Dan, to be my husband.
I promise before God and these friends.
I promise before God and these friends.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To share with you in plenty and in want.
To share with you in plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
And to join with you so that together.
And to join with you so together.
We may serve God and others.
We may serve God and others.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
And so today, my challenge to you is that as you take these vows, as you take this step, that you would very consciously and remind yourself over and over and over again on this journey that today you laid aside the story of Dan and you very intentionally and very missionally picked up the story of Rebecca. And today you laid aside the story of Rebecca and you very intentionally and passionately picked up the story of Dan. And now you live for one another as you pursue God together. Thank you.
Rebecca.
I give this ring to you as a token of the covenant made.
I give this ring to you as a token of the covenant made.
Between us this day.
Between us this day.
And as a pledge of our mutual love.
As a pledge of our mutual love.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
You'll get it.
It's getting there.
Keep trying.
Go on.
And Rebecca, in return.
Dan?
I give this ring to you.
I give this ring to you.
As a token of the covenant made between us this day.
As a token of the covenant made between us this day.
And as a pledge of our mutual love.
And as a pledge of our mutual love.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
A lot of the people on my side of the family think of us sort of as, you know, two peas in a pod, you know, conjoined at the hips. Me personally, I like to think of us as just sort of like the same person. Just in sense we're one person, just having gone through two different paths. So I think Rebecca knows by now that, you know, our relationship is a little, it's a bit unique, you know? Yeah. I mean, it's true. Hey, calm down, son. Yeah. I mean, we are on that level, Danny, where I could just, I already know what you're gonna do before you do it. It's crazy, I don't get it. Yeah. Bless you, by the way. Yeah. Don't worry, Rebecca, you'll get on that level too. Just give it some time. No, it's not meant to be a diss. No, give it time.
One thing has always been evident, how much Rebecca loves Danny. I remember Rebecca would always say, Danny's never jealous. And that's because Danny always knew how much she cared about him.
Red, green, and indigo, we go together like the colors of our rainbow. Shining through your window.
With the delicateness of a flower. Even though a flower bends in many ways, it's still fragile. And know that Rebecca loves you immensely. And to Rebecca, listen to Danny. Hear him out sometime. Because Danny always cares to do what's best for you.
Can you see? Ooh, la 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 la. This magical moment in life. Ooh, la 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 la. Comes together like a lightning strike. You look in my eyes and hold on tight. And the storm turns and I can find you by my side. Ooh, la 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 la. This magical moment.
not sure what I did to be so blessed to have such a wonderful family. We met Rebecca 22 years ago, and I don't know how life could be better without her. She's my little girl, always will be. You can borrow her, but you can't have her. We're just very lucky. Danny's a wonderful young man, and I can't think of anyone more special to welcome into our family as well. So thank you all for coming, and please and help us enjoy a beautiful evening together. Thank you.
Man.
It's a little grooming station for you.
Put it around here. Yeah. Gosh, you smell good now.
Best friends, they pick up traits from each other. Some better kept with the person they came from. Rebecca would always say, I can't see myself with Danny. until one day we saw her with Danny.
Thank you.
like many best friends. They've picked up traits from one another. I remember one day I was doing my homework and Rebecca was watching a movie and she started to laugh. And I turned around because she was laughing like Danny.
We'll be right back.
I said before that you and I are going to down two different paths. Well, your path has led you to find the love of your life. God has given you this precious gift. Now you need to treasure it and cherish it with all your heart. Rebecca, first off, you know, welcome to the family. I want to thank you for showing support to Danny, especially these last 2 years in college. They're incredibly tough on him, and I, since the bottom of my heart, just thank you for sticking out with him. I think you're an intelligent, loving, caring, and overall an amazing person. And I want you, I want to see that love and support you've given him so far. I want you to carry forward over the rest of your lives together. I've had the privilege to witness the love that you two share. That's a little loud. I know I have, but yeah, back then it was astonishing to me how well you guys communicated and how you've come to accept each other's faults just as easily as you've accepted each other's strengths. Desearle que ese amor que ellos tienen que siga fundada en Dios si siga creciendo durante los años.
Yeah.
Dear Daniel, I can't believe our wedding day is already here. It seems like just yesterday we met the first day of the summer college program in 2007.
Sweet patience, it's been a long, cold September with the soft rain of silence falling in. Sweet patience, with your strong arms to carry and your steadfast light to take us through this town.
The first thing I remember was your distinguished musical laugh. I never heard such a laugh in my life. Well, did I know that it would become one of my favorite sounds in the world.
Sweet memory, all your pages tell the story, with the tears and memories through it all.
You are my first and only love. I pray for you more than I pray for anyone in this world. I know that God put you in my life for a reason. I didn't realize it at first, but from day one, God's love has just been pouring from you.
A sweet memory, all your goodness covers over, so the shadows will not find us after all. It's here. And waiting on the other side, on the side, love is waiting. Oh, it's here, when morning meets the edge of night, that the sun will rise.
Dan and Rebecca have consented to join together in marriage and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and have pledged their mutual love to each other and have declared the same by the giving and receiving of rings and by joining hands. I declare that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
May God be the foundation of your marriage, and may you have a blessed and fruitful marriage. And I toast to you, Danny and Rebecca.
Don't let go, love will be enough. You're stronger than you know. You're stronger than you know. Come alive, don't let go.
By the power invested in me by the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you man and wife. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Dan and Rebecca Sanchez.
You were there when I first put my faith in the Lord, my struggles, and every time after. I want you as a constant in my life forever, and I can't wait to marry you today. I hope whenever you wear this, you'll be reminded of this perfect, beautiful day, the start of our life together.
Come alive, don't let go, love will be enough. You're stronger.
I was Danny's best friend. But now that title rightfully belongs to you. He's your top priority. And you're his. Take care of him, okay?
You look incredible. You look incredible. Babe, you look amazing. You look incredible. Oh my gosh. I love you too.